Thank you and good afternoon everyone. Thank you for joining my session. In this session, I will talk about supercharging machine learning tasks that supercharging is meaning improving training, improving speed of training model with lay and open source unified compute framework. Let me introduce myself first. My name is Swasey Wathamathorn, but you can also call me Khom. I'm now computer engineering student at KMUTT, and now I'm a student at Microsoft Learn Student Ambassador. Today, I will talk about this agenda. Firstly, I will introduce today, and next two, I will expand what is lay, and next, I will expand why is lay and core feature of lay, and in the last one, I will demo in lay with machine learning task. Firstly, let me explain what is distributed computing. Distributed computing is one method of computational tasks that are divided and executed across multiple computers. You can see from this structure, you can see that it's one computer of your computer, and you can divide and execute across multiple computers at in your network. It can enhance processing and efficiency and reliability with it. So it can distributed computing is used for large-scale data pre-processing, machine learning, and cloud service. That is offering advantage like improved speed, scalability, and fault tolerance. Next one, everyone know. I think everyone know about parallel computing. What is different of it? You can see from a graph that. You can see that distributed computing is a device and computer and can across execute it. But in a parallel computing is in a one device and divide a task and execute in the same device. Now, what is lay? Lay is an open source and unified compute framework that can scalability open source platform that designed for distributed computing, and it can simplify the development and management for complex distributed application. And it's focusing on enhancing machine learning workflow. Lay is integrated with a popular machine learning framework and provides specialized library for tasks like reinforcement learning, hyperparameter tuning, and model serving. And it's a logo of Lay. Next one is history of Lay. Lay is foundation at UC Berkeley in a light lab. First purpose of that, they want to address challenge in scalable and distributed computing, especially for AI and machine learning tasks. And now Lay is a widely adopted framework. Lay has evolved with a robust ecosystem, including specialized library for various ML tasks. And it's used globally for diverse large-scale distributed computing application. Why is Lay? Firstly, I will expand about key feature of Lay. It can divide into three features. Firstly, on top is a Lay AI library. Lay AI library includes specialized tools like RLLIF for reinforcement learning, Lay Tune for hyperparameter tuning, and Lay Serve for model deployment. And you can see that Lay Train and Lay Data that it can provide data from Lay platform, and you can training Lay with Lay.train. Next one is Lay Call. Lay Call is provide a simple yet powerful API for building and running distributed application, and it's offering feature like dynamic task parallelism, distributed state machine, distributed state management, and seamless scalability from a single machine to large cluster. And the last one is a cloud, or it can say that it's a Lay cluster. It's a set worker node connect to a common Lay head node Lay cluster can be a fixed size but in the Lay core it cannot fixed size but Lay cluster it can do it so it can auto scale up and down according to the resource that request by application running on the cluster okay what is different Lay from other compute framework you can see that Lay is focusing on AI and ML framework Lay is unique tool for AI and machine learning tasks offering special library and seamless integration with popular ML framework you can see that Lay can use Hugging Face DeepSeed PyTorch and can use GPU for or other hardware that that fit from Lay and it unlike many general purpose distributed computing system and also Lay is a dynamic task graph execution Lay can ability to dynamically execute tasks provide greater flexibility and efficient for iterative and adaptive computation setting it apart from framework with static SQ model next one is a Lay in real world application now Lay is a embed in a Uber that is optimized their end-to-end deep learning workflow by using Lay as the distributed backend for their machine learning platform. Lay flexibility and extendability and low maintenance overhead mode Lay a clear winner over alternative. And you can see an example of using Lay on this link. It can use with a generative AI and LM and whatever it can use with AI now. Next one is my demo. In my demo, I will part demo in four computing that fully is use traditional machine learning. In my demo, I will test with MNIST dataset that everyone will know it. It's a flower and it's a number 0 to 9. And I list dataset is a flower. You can see that example of MNIST is more than iList. And you can see I will train it in a 100 epoch because I want to test at speed of traditional computing, parallel computing, and distributed computing. You can see that after I test it with 100 epoch with one core CPU, it used runtime about 300 seconds, about 5 minutes. And in our iList data, it used only 1 second because it's a small data set. And next one, I using Lay for test it that it can reduce time and this result is this. You can see that if use Lay, it can reduce your time from 300 seconds to 90 seconds is about 1.5 minutes. And it use the same epoch that is 100 epoch. And I config is distributed computing with a 16 core CPU. And I will expand code later. And in iList data, I do it same. And you can see that runtime is more than traditional machine learning because it's a low, it's a small data set that is not fit for distributed computing because distributed computing is fit for large data set. And next one, I using a parallel computing for testing the same. In parallel computing, it's reduce your time too. You can see that it use time about 80 seconds is about 9. It's about 1.5 minutes. And I use 100 epoch too. And I use a CPU that 16 core using parallel. And in iList, I using the same. But in iList, it use runtime more than traditional machine learning. And in the last one, I test it with quantum computing, but in quantum computing, I do not finish in MNIST data because it's hardly for embed data, but I fit it for iList dataset, and you can see that it use runtime about 17 seconds, but runtime this is simulate because in quantum hardware now it's full queue to run it on a real quantum hardware. I use simulate quantum computing. It's used about 17 seconds. I forgot to change it. It's used a quantum computing. And the last one, you can see the graph that in MNIST data, you can see that if we use traditional training with 100 epoch, it's used time about 5 minutes, and its graph is also following. And if you use distributed and parallel computing, it can reduce your time for training, and you can speed up machine learning model training. But I suggest is that if you use a large data set, I suggest you use distributed and parallel computing. But if you training in a small data set, I suggest you use a traditional machine learning model, machine learning. Next is advantage and challenge of Ray. Okay, it's Ray is had a challenge now. Firstly, it's a complex in large scale deployment because it uses many require specialized expertise to large scale deployment, as it's too more complex for using Ray. And next one is resource intensiveness because Ray is high performance come with significant resource demand, particularly in terms of memory and CPU usage, which can be challenging in resource constrained environment or require substantial infrastructure investment. The next one is code that I use ChatGPT for generate for this session. ChatGPT tell us in the world of technology, it's not about the strongest or most intelligent that will thrive, but those who can best manage change or you can improve speed up for training data. Ray is embody this principle in the realm of distributed computing, continuous adapting, and evolve to supercharge our journey in machine learning and AI. And the last one is demo repository. You can see the code and test it. But now I will show how to use Ray. Firstly, I will test it with MNIST data. First, you need to lay in it to initial lay on your script, and then you download MNIST data. Next, you need to lay .remote for initial function that you will remote it to distributed computing. It's important. You need to type at lay.remote. And you can define a simple neural network model and whatever that you want to remote it to distributed computing. And the next one, I speed data set for distributed computing. That initial chunk is 16, and you can adjust based on your cluster setup. And then I forward for num chunk and speed data into 16. And the last one, I measure the time that and training the model with dot remote, that it can be send your function that you initial in at lay dot remote to a distributed computing, and it can reduce your time for training a lot. You can see that it will be use speed data into 16, and you can see that it is not the continuous training because it split into 16 data. And the last one, you can see the output is time taken is 90 seconds. And the accuracy is so good also with the same traditional machine learning. Thank you for listening. And I'm so sorry for my speaking because in the first, I prepared it for Thai language, but now I see it had a foreigner. I adapt it to English. Sorry for that.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Kap Khom. Actually, we still have a plenty of time. So maybe anyone have questions to come to asking about the Ray Anyone have any questions? You can ask in Thai or English as well. Yep.
Can we use Ray in Google Colab?
Yes. We install Ray.
We can use like your code and put in Google Colab and just install Ray.
Yes.
Thank you.
And you can see at Ray document for other library of Ray, such as Ray Core.
For Ray, like which kind of computing resources we can actually access through, like can we use all the cloud services and everything?
Yes, it can use with cloud service too. You can use Ray cluster for connect with your cloud. It's fit for Kubernetes, Azure, GCP, and AWS.
And if we have like our own GPUs, we can connect it yes. locally as well.
Okay, yes.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you for your interesting presentation. For me, I have a question. When comparing to when I train with a PyTorch or with a train with other, they have the option like a data parallel when training like the multiple GPU in one PC. I see from the lay is designed to be a distributed yes. PC. So is it quite unsure that if I have only one PC but they have many GPU, does lay can be applied with a multiple GPU?
I'm not sure with it. I use lay for training in a CPU, but in a GPU, multi GPU, I not sure with it. I will find and I will answer you later.
Excuse me, talk to question to Thai.
Yes,
yes. Okay. ครับถามว่าควอนตัมคอมพิวเตอร์ครับตอนนี้ได้ทดลองเทสหรือยังครับ
เทสเรียบร้อยครับแต่เทสแค่กับI test quantum computing with Alice data because in an MD data and don't finish implement it and it's in a quantum computing, I test it with quantum simulation that is not the same quantum hardware. It's a simulate quantum in a classical computer with a KISS library from IBM. And it's used runtime about 17 seconds.
I have a question. So you show us four approaches, and I'm not sure what's the difference between the second and third, the distributed and parallel.
Oh, not sure about the difference of parallel and distributed. I think if distributed computing is fit form, if you want to separate device, แบบ if you ตอบภาษาไทยได้ไหมวันนี้ก็คือถ้าสมมติ distributed computing แบบถ้าสมมติองค์กรแบบมีคอมแบบหลายเครื่องที่ไม่ใช้งานนะครับก็คือแนะนำตัว distributed computing มากกว่าก็คือแบบไปใช้เราสามารถใช้คอมเครื่องนี้แล้วก็ไปเชื่อมต่อกับอีกคอมเครื่องนึงได้เหมือนเขียนพวก open MPI ครับหรือ open MP อันหนึ่งครับที่แบบใช้ในการทำ distributed computing ก็คือแบบเหมาะกับงานพวกนี้มากกว่าแต่ถ้าสมมติเราแบบรันบนเครื่องเดียวแล้วเราต้องการใช้คอบนเครื่องให้มันคุ้มที่สุดแนะนำเป็น parallel computing มากกว่า okay. ไม่รู้ว่าเขาจะถูกไหมครับเสริมได้นะครับทุกคน
Another question does Ray help with the inference and model serving process?
Yes.
Does it work?
In my demo it work for improve inference.